People often tell others that things are relative, or to view things from someone else's frame of reference, but where did this terminology come from, and what does it really mean? To go back to the origin of these terms, we have to go back to the 17th century and talk to a man named Galileo. Galileo not only measured things that happened, but considered them from other frames of reference. Now let's look at a modern example of this phenomenon that was considered hundreds of years ago. Imagine yourself on a train that is moving at a constant speed, and you drop a ball at the window. From your point of view, it appears to fall straight down. Now let's imagine it from the point of view of somebody standing on the street. From their point of view, the ball moves forward. These two points of view can be called frames of reference, and even more specifically than that, inertial frames of reference. An inertial frame of reference is a frame of reference that is moving at a constant velocity, or one that is not moving at all. This is because one at a constant velocity and one that is not moving at all feel the same. This could be seen with the train example, as the person on the train saw the ball drop straight down, as someone standing still would have. Everything considered so far has been Galilean relativity, but to get an even larger appreciation for relativity, we need to look at more recent examples. James Clerk Maxwell summarized electricity and magnetism into four equations. The last two predicted that electric and magnetic fields can form self-propagating waves whenever a charge is accelerated. These equations predicted the speed of light. Just as importantly, Maxwell's equations didn't specify a frame of reference for light. This whole video can be summarized as the two postulates of special relativity. From Galileo, we understand that all inertial frames are equivalent, and from Maxwell, we know the speed of light in a vacuum is invariant.